All right, I know the title says Clairo Fanboy, and I know that might be a little bit confusing because obviously this is my first time listening to Immunity. So you might be thinking, how are you a fanboy if you haven't even heard half her albums? Which kind of makes sense, but I would consider myself a fanboy. Sling was one of my favorite records of 2021 easily. It came out in 2019. It's 11 songs, 40 minutes. The uncut reaction is going to be on Patreon, link in the description as always to go join that. And yeah, Clairo Immunity. Let's get it. Production actually isn't that different from Slade. Feels pretty similar. Cool drums. Really live feel to these drums. Loving those. It definitely has more of like an indie rock vibe, I feel like. Sling was definitely more folky. This, you got those kind of more heavy drums, a lot of reverb in the mix as well, which kind of gives me this indie vibe and this kind of live feel to it. Not that Sling didn't feel live, it just felt a little bit more intimate. So this is definitely a switch up sonically, I guess. Pretty distorted bass. Interesting how they throw, because it's a pretty soft track, but then they throw that rough distortion in there too. That was pretty good. We're just gonna give it the good rating, I guess. Yeah, sonically pretty different. Let me get the lyrics up here too. I like it lyrically too. It seems that it's maybe about a friend or something. It all seems pretty personal, which her writing usually is, but it's been so long, you've been my sister all along, you know, I'll be all right. Eighth grade was never that tight. Who helped stop her from ending her life when she was in eighth grade? Dang, okay. I mean, when she said eighth grade, I immediately thought of the Bo Burnham film. Powerful lyrically, I liked the sound a lot. Again, it's a switch up, but I'm here for it. Okay, and it's making sense here too. You called me 7 times. Didn't mean to scare you, just had the thoughts in my mind. So she's having these thoughts, of course, and she calls her. Pretty depressing start, but kind of hopeful too with that friend obviously stepping in and helping her out. Yeah, a lot more heavy drums right off the bat compared to Sling. It's so confusing. That bass line. I'm loving the drums on this. Sound great. Okay. This kind of fuzz she has on her vocals right now are pretty interesting. I'm used to like a clean Clairo vocal, but this is a cool different sound. Those background vocals. Okay, that track's far from perfect, but I'm still gonna give it the solid rating. The part that I don't really enjoy is those kind of bland piano chords that come in. They came in on the chorus at the end there, and they came in a couple other times. Like I said, that kind of fuzz she had on her vocals was kind of cool, because I'm, again, used to hearing a more clean and more intimate clairol vocal, so that was a cool switch up sonically. This feels a little bit more mainstream than Sling, definitely, but that's not inherently a bad thing. On that track, I think it was to its fault a little bit with those kind of just really bland chords that came in. It felt like something I would hear in like a top 40 song, you know. Other than that, really good track. I like the lyrics again, super personal. Next track is Closer to You. Shout out Frank Ocean. Does it sound like a Frank Ocean song? Definitely. I feel it in my bones. Auto-tune? Okay. Different. Mama said I told you so. Shut up. Don't wanna hear it, now I'm fed up. This is interesting. What the heck? Okay, seems like we got a maybe a kind of abusive relationship here. Maybe not. I don't know. Wow. I was not loving this at first, but it's grown on me. I actually really liked that. That was sick. We'll give it the good again. Nothing's really blown me away to merit a 10 yet, but lyrically, that was really interesting too. It seemed like it was kind of about like a maybe felt like it was an about like abusive relationship, maybe. Don't want to hear it now, I'm fed up. I know it won't change, I know I'll still feel this way, and then the things you do only make me want to get closer to you, so maybe like some manipulation or something. Okay, kind of what I said. She says feeling like I'm not enough, me feeling like I know this is wrong, but maybe I can be the one person that changes them. Pretty interesting lyrically. Again, nothing groundbreaking, but I think it's written in a pretty honest, personal way. I wish there was a little bit more depth to it and a little bit more, I don't know, I just feel like that's something Clairo did better on Sling, which makes sense because she was older in that album, obviously, so the writing is going to be more mature. But that's definitely something I'm noticing, is the writing is a little bit more simple on this. I'm nervous, couldn't tell you why. Touching me hands, oh, dirty feel of this one. This is really distorted and like not in a good way, not in a tasteful way at all. Like those vocals with that guitar really blown out. Holy. Like it's actually hurting my ears. This hurts, man. That was not good. Why is it so blown out? Why is it so distorted? Okay, I hate to do it. I really actually do hate to do it. That shit stank, don't it? That was not good. That was not good. Yes, I know you can do distorted stuff. You can do stuff like that purposefully and make it sound good and make it feel like it fits, but that just felt completely out of place. It felt like it was done not in a way, not with skill. It felt like it was done more like as a mistake and more amateurish-y. Amateurish-y? What am I saying? That's not even a word. It was not listenable at all. The mix was really bad. I was liking it at first. I liked the dirty sound was kind of tolerable at first because it wasn't completely distorted, but as the track went on, it got even more blown out and distorted, and her vocals were just really scratchy and clipping and just a lot of unpleasant stuff. And again, you can do that in songs, but it has a very specific time and place when it actually works. And I don't think it actually worked here. I actually do think the lyrics on here are a little bit more enjoyable on a first listen compared to Sling, because they kind of hit you more directly. They feel a little bit more relatable because they're so, like, they're just so general. I feel like most of these people, can I talk? Why did I say most of these people? Most people can relate to the stuff she's singing about. It was just the sound of that track that was just really unlistenable. Maybe, I don't know, I feel like that was a mistake. Like, maybe it was my headphones, but that just did not sound good. Hold getting like Taylor Swift vibes too with this album, definitely, in terms of the songwriting. I don't know why, I really like that phrasing of cases under the bed. She did that too with Can You Figure Me Out. This is weird. This piano, it's a little bit distorted as well. It's giving me like the microphones vibes. Like I was not expecting this to be so like, I mean, two tracks in a row where it feels kind of distorted. On this one, I think it's working a little bit better, but it's still something to kind of get used to. I love that break with the drums. Man, this is kind of disappointing because, I mean, I'm going to give that one the mid. And the only reason really is because of the mixing again. It was just so, the clipping and the distorting, it just, I don't know, it just, it's not working for me. It wasn't as harsh on that track, but there was still a lot of it. And it kind of ruined the, just the emotion of the track. Like, I just couldn't really enjoy it because it was just kind of unlistenable. Again, I like the lyrics on that one. They're a little bit more simple with that one, I feel like, but they're still pretty solid. I like the chords. I like the instrumental. I just wish it wasn't so blown out. That's like really my only complaint, but it's such a big factor that it makes it kind of unlistenable and it makes it not great. This has like a Steve Lacy vibe to it. Sounds so good. Like, this is listenable, it's a clean chorus, her vocals sound pristine, fun little guitar. Okay, so I knew something about Clairo kind of coming out on this album. I guess this is kind of alluding to that because she sang girl in this song. I mean, I think Sophia, I read something about Sophia or heard something about Sophia, and that kind of touches on it more, so we'll see. But yeah, definitely talking about a girl here. Ah, those vocals. They're mixed so good. Just right in your ear. One pan to the left, one pan to the right. There you go. That was amazing. That was really, really good. That's easily my favorite track so far. Obviously kind of alluding to her coming out. That was a beautiful ending too. I don't care what they say. I'm doing it differently. Kind of going against the traditional idea of love, obviously, between a man and a woman. But yeah, again, it's nothing groundbreaking, but I just feel like it's a pretty touching, heartwarming track. And the sound is really the thing that stuck out to me on that one. I love the drums. I love just the pristine recording of it. Her vocals were mixed so perfectly. And yeah, that was a lot better than the past two. I think we could do it if we tried. For me to say you're mine. I think we could do it if we tried. For me to say. Hear that guitar. Just jamming. I'm loving this phrasing too. Clairo's like one of my favorite vocalists, hands down. See, it kind of works here. Cause it led into it in a nice way. And it's not during the whole track either, you know? That's another good track. I mean, it's easily the most streamed on here. You can definitely see why. We're going to give it the good rating. Again, talking about some of the similar stuff as the last track. Shouldn't Feel Like a Crime, You and I. Sound was pretty good, again. I liked the groove on that one. The guitars were great. And the distorted bit, it led into it, so it didn't feel out of place. It didn't get irritating. It only happened for like 15 seconds, maybe. And then it went away, and it kind of led into that with the glissandoing. I can't remember what that was, but it led into it really nicely. It kind of prepared you for it. I mean, other than North and Begs, this album has been pretty solid. It's just those two that really were kind of disappointing. Oh, those are nice chords. Cool drums. Heavy kick. Again, I like everything that's here. It's just the slightly distorted and clipping nature of it that makes it not as good as it could be, in my opinion. It's a beautiful ending. Oh, so warm and synthy. It's the second time we've had the kind of voiceover too. That was all right. I mean, I don't think I'll return to it, but I'm actually going to give it the good rating. I was going to give it the mid, but it kind of saved itself, if I'm being honest, with that outro. And I kind of got more into that sound, the more kind of distorted nature of it. Lyrically talking about a breakup, but wanting to be still friends after. Pretty lit, relatable. I like that Loveless line, of course, that Lord reference. Pretty decent. I mean, it had a kind of a hip-hop feel to it too, with the heavy kick and how everything was side-chained to that kick as well. The distorted sound, it was getting a little bit on my nerve, but it wasn't as obnoxious on that one, so pretty decent. Probably won't return to it, but not the worst thing ever. Yo, this lighting is so good right now. What the heck? Bro, I should film my videos at 9 at night all the time. Instrumental's a bit boring, if I'm being honest. I hope that picks up. I'm assuming it will. I feel like we've already covered this stuff lyrically too. I'm at the point where I wish Clairo would kind of cover these topics with a little bit more depth and nuance. Like, it was fine for the first couple tracks, but now I feel like we're recycling ideas, recycling themes, and just getting a little bit boring. Okay, we're gonna give it the mid. Like I said, I feel like we're just kind of recycling themes and ideas now. Like I said, it was fine for the first couple tracks, but it's kind of falling flat on its face now. Definitely in Sling, you can see Clairo, her writing improved so much. Like, this isn't terrible, but there's just not as much depth to it. Vocals are still a little bit hot, like there's a little bit of clipping and distortion, you can tell, but I might be able to excuse it for this track because it's not terrible. That little synth, oh. Oh, sounds great. I remember hearing all those beautiful background vocals on Sling. It's giving me Sling vibes. That's pretty good. I do have a couple complaints. Again, the vocals, when she got into her higher notes and you could tell she's pushing her voice a little bit, it's a little bit of clipping, a little bit of distortion. That just wasn't very pleasant, but I think I can kind of excuse that because the rest of the track was pretty amazing. It's just a super smooth instrumental, super smooth vocal flows over top of that. This idea of sinking, pretty sad, honestly, lyrically. It's getting cold. Why does it feel like I'm older than I asked to be? Yeah, pretty sad. Oh, geez. Wait, what? I just read here it. Let me get it on here. Something about arthritis? I would have never realized that without this freaking genius annotation. So thank you. Thank you, genius, as much as people hate you sometimes. Here, wait, let me look at these lyrics now. What am I doing? Oh, so she's kind of, kind of questioning why it has to be her that has this at such a young age. That sucks, man. Last track here is 6 minutes and 56 seconds long. Hopefully it doesn't drag on at all. Oh, we got parts. Part one. Okay. Kanye vibes? Auto-tune and children's choir? We got, like, College Dropout with the college, or with the children's choir, and then the auto-tune with 808s, you know? Kanye vibes. Okay, I like it. Why are children's choirs just always so good? There's something just about the innocence that's just super heartwarming. I mean, not always, because, you know, you got, what, freaking Kids Bop and stuff, but... Okay, that is a reference to Frank Ocean. I thought I recognized that, but yeah, it came off of Pilot Jones, off Channel Orange. I think he says the exact same thing. I would ask you to take care of me. Part two. I like that organ. It's nice. Woo! This weirdly feels kind of Frank Ocean. Yes, that guitar sounds so good. Oh. Oh, how did they get the guitar sound, man? There you go. I'll convince a friend to join deep ends. That was a solid ending. 6 minute, almost 7 minute track. I mean, it was dragging on a little bit, but the fact that it was split into two parts helped it not feel so long. I mean, 7 minutes isn't like that long, but you know what I mean. I like the lyrics too. It kind of felt like it was talking about her arthritis again. I wouldn't ask you to take care of me, kind of highlighting that. Maybe she feels like it's too hard for someone to take care of her. Yeah, another pretty solid track. Not one of my favorites, but a pretty good ender. This album was actually pretty solid. It had me scared for a little bit there when we had North and Bags, definitely, because those tracks were kind of not great, in my opinion. But the rest of the album, while it's not perfect, it's pretty solid. It's pretty solid. Not as good as Sling, definitely, in my opinion. I think the writing on Sling is a lot more mature and interesting and deep and nuanced. I think the production is better too with Jack Antonoff. He kills it with the production on Sling. Claro, obviously, the singing was fantastic, of course. I feel like the singing was a little bit ruined with some of the vocal effects sometimes. Sometimes I feel like it helped and created some interesting sounds, but for the most part, I like hearing Claro's raw, kind of intimate, clean vocals, because I think she just has a great voice, one of my favorite voices, period, in terms of music. So I would have liked to hear it a little bit more clear, more often, but it was cool hearing a sonic switch up, definitely. Yeah, there you go. Claro, Immunity, pretty solid. I think I actually classify it as a fanboy now, so there you go. Shout out Claro. All right, I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm running out of things to say. Peace out.